What's up, guys? This is Matt with Flagstaff Camera, and today we're going to talk a little bit about why you might want to buy an older, uglier film camera instead of the fancy, shiny, expensive ones. Let's dive in. So let's talk a little bit about film cameras. You have the very nice, expensive ones. Name brand, typically Nikon, Canon, Contax, that kind of thing. And you have the sort of lesser known cameras, like some of the Pentaxes, some of the Minoltas, some of the stuff that's not nearly as popular, that's not nearly as famous on Instagram. And then even the name brand cameras like Nikon, Canon, whatever, have these sort of extremely 90s versions that are less popular and they're therefore less expensive. But the great thing is with film, most of these cameras are pretty much the same. They all do mostly the same stuff. So as long as you're okay with having a slightly chunkier body or a body with more buttons than dials, or you know, if you don't necessarily have a preference for lenses, you can get film camera gear for less than half the cost, less than a quarter of the cost of the big expensive name brand stuff that works just as great. Sometimes it works better. For instance, to get this beautiful little Minolta kit here, you might spend $50, $75. And then to buy a 50mm 1.4 lens or a 135 f2.8, I mean, these lenses are cheap. You might spend $50, $75 a piece on these lenses versus the Nikon equivalent, which will be, you know, $200 for a kit like this plus extra lenses. And they're effectively the same. I mean, yes, they're not exactly the same. There are some slight differences, but in terms of everyday normal shooting, you're going to get way more gear for way less money if you're willing to have something that doesn't say Nikon on it or something that doesn't say Canon, whatever. People ask me what kind of camera they should get into, or, you know, should I buy the Nikon or the Canon? Look at the Minoltas. Look at the Pentaxes. Look at some of the other off-brand Yashica whatever style cameras that have great glass and will serve you very well. They'll last very long, they're very reliable. They'll cost a lot less. And then later, if you decide you need to spend a whole bunch of money on a camera, you can get into your Nikons, your Leicas, your whatever expensive cameras. And you'll find that they're basically the same. Maybe that's just me. Maybe I'm just that guy who doesn't really care about how it looks. I care about how it works. Anyway, so that's why you might consider getting into some less expensive cameras. At least to start, at least to play around with different lenses, focal lengths. That's it. See you in the next one.